Hi gamers, I'm Cyber Settler, and today we're playing Space Engineers. Today we're continuing with the Eagle Transporter use case series, and today we are focusing on hauling. So I have this storage module, and we want to deploy this to the already installed refinery station that we have nearby. And this storage module will help us with refined material that will be processed in our refinery. So we have to pick up this module and install it. That's one part of what we are going to do today. And also we are going to be transporting some material back here to the base, some refined material. But first, let's store the prospector module that we have currently attached to the Eagle Transporter. So what we're going to do is that we're going to detach the prospector, and then we are going to store this in our storage, into our module storage facility. As you remember, in our last video we were reviewing this facility. So as you can see, the base is a little bit dusty. It's a reddish dust, though, that I don't know, here in the moon we shouldn't have so much red material, right? Iron rich material, should I say. Okay, the first thing is that we are going to we're going to lower the prospector module. And now I think we can just go and pick up our storage module. So let's turn on the engines. This is also the our batteries are 88%. I think everything is fine. Okay, so let's go for it. Also, we will be doing something with how it's called, with we won't just be transporting material. You will see what we're going to do. So let's turn this off. So if you will remember from the last times we have we've been maneuvering with the Eagle Transporter, it maneuvers quite well with this lift thrusters on. So we all the time we have the flight assist on, but we disable the this reaction control systems thrusters, and then we have like this nice movement. Let's see. Okay. Okay, we are not aligned. Let's, yeah, that way. So this is a large container, what we have here. It's a large container, and we have a connector at the top, and we have some tubes at the sides, and these tubes are on mergeable blocks. This is from the CJ's on mergeable block mod, and you are going to see how I think this is the first time I will use this feature from the modules, and you will see how they scale. This is used to like scaling the to build to connect modules between each other, and you will see soon what do I mean by that. Oh, I think I'm a little bit off. Let's see. Ah, of course. I have the connect the ports turned off. Okay, now they're on. Now, okay, that's it. And now we will there we go. There we have the module attached. Okay, so what I was saying is that you will see how these modules can fit with each other, because in the other episode where we were building the where we were installing the refinery, we had a power module and a and the refinery, and the way we built that was in a stacking one to the other, right? We took a screenshot there. It's nice, a nice view of the Eagle Transporter shadow. Okay, so there you can see it in the distance, right? We have the a stack. We have the refinery in the bottom, in like in the base, and on top of that we have a solar power module, solar power plant, I should say. And what we want to do is that we want to connect the storage module to the refinery. And I want to show you guys how we will do that. Let's start our descent, because we are 300 meters altitude. I want to decrease that a little bit. Let's okay, now we need a different perspective here. Which one is it? I think it's this one. We want just to place the refinery next to the we want to place the storage module next to the refinery. Okay, but we don't want it to be very close. Okay, let's take a view from outside. Yeah, So you see here, yeah, we need a little bit to go a little bit more forward. And you see here that we can face some trouble because the Eagle transporter is so big that that we could clash with the other structure. So this is the other use case for hauling, because hauling could be also to move things around, not just like carry goods from one place to another, but also to move equipment. And in this case, now we are seeing that we need like to move, we will need to move an equipment, and because the Eagle transporter is too big to maneuver in this case. And what we want to do is to connect this connector here, this merge block, and this tube here to this merge block of the refinery with the tube of the refinery. So we would need to get the Eagle transporter very close. So let's see if we can we just want to be close enough. Probably that's enough. Okay, let's see how it's now. Yeah, we're almost there. I think we need to move a little bit more forward. Or maybe that's... or maybe to the side. There. There we go. So we've got probably what I would need to do is just to extend a little bit these other blocks. There. Okay. So, where am I going? No, not that. We need to move it a little bit forward. There we go. And there we are. Like it's connected in both sides. So now we can just leave it here. So you can see that, oops. I think I you can see here that we are really close like to this panel, right? The Eagle transporter is very close to this panel, and in order to connect this module to this one, it will be a little bit tricky. One way to overcome this is like to fold the panels. That we could do that. We can just fold the panels and try to do this maneuver. But I want to show you guys the other use case of hauling, like that is moving things around. And we have something prepared for that. So let's return to the base. Let's disconnect the storage module. And let's head back to the base, and we're going to fetch a special equipment that I've designed for this other use case, for this other let's say scenario of this use case. Okay. So we need to attach a special equipment to the Eagle transporter that will let us it will let us move the module, the storage module, without being in such a close proximity with the rest of the structure in our refinery station. And I want to show you guys how do we do that. Okay, so we are almost there. Let's start our descent. Okay, the storage module is still on the elevator. We have to store that. Okay. Okay, I don't know if I'm in the right position here. Almost right. Okay, let's wow, that was a big bang right there. Ah, but it's connected. It's perfect. Okay. Okay, so we have our Eagle transporter in position now, and we need to. I will be turning off all these things now. Okay, so let's go ahead. First, we need like to store the module. The prospector module stored in one of the hangar. So currently I have two hangars. In the last video I had only one hangar. And you see now that we have like these four buttons, like deploy hangar one or store it, deploy hangar two and store it. We're going to store in hangar one. And let's go and check that out. First person here, so you see how the storing mechanism works. So it will take this this module here, which should activate the prospector landing gears lock. Let's set them to lock so they don't move around. They tend to move around quite a lot. There we go. And now it's storing the module in its position. So this I explained that this system works with three programmable blocks. One acting as a controller, the other one as a sensor, and the other one as executor. It's somewhat complex system, but I separated all these things in these three different domains. So here we are, we have stored the prospector module in hangar one, this hangar two, and we need to deploy this one. And as you can see here, this is some sort of crane. It's a crane module. And this is what we're going to use to move the storage module around without getting too close to the refinery, to the power plant block. So let's deploy hangar two. So, by the way, I haven't done this yet, so this will be a test. So you know how tests are. Sometimes they don't work as expected, but I wanted to test these things with you guys so you can share my my anxiety with this kind of things. So here we go. I mean, this is working quite well, I should say. All these things with the transferring of the platform between between merge blocks and pistons and things, between all these mechanisms. And now we're going to rise the elevator, and this button right here. We should see it from here. We can take a screenshot. I like this view when when the modules are being deployed. Okay, but that's not all. I think we need to extend this piston right here so it can reach up there, and it will be like around 5 meters more or less. Yes, I think 5 meters would do. So let's rise it until 5 meters, and then we will just lock. Where is it? We can just set the maximum distance to 5 meters, and let's reverse. There we go. I think that's a good. Yeah. We should also turn off this other. I don't remember which ones were this. This other, how it's called, merge blocks. Which ones are this? Reload ports. Let's turn them off. Okay. Okay, so I turn off the load ports here, and now I will turn on maybe I should move a little bit the minimum distance. I should put it at 4.8, and I should reverse it a little bit. Okay, so there we go, and I should turn on the load ports now. Just turn them on. They're on. There. Perfect. Now we have everything attached, and we should, let's name this crane piston. Crane piston, that's it. Okay, and now we are just going to bind these things. The crane piston, I will, now we change, right? Like the minimum distance is 0 and the maximum distance is the 10 we had before. And let's bind all these actions from the crane. The groups will be the this crane, where are they? Crane load ports. We will toggle them on and off, and the crane piston, we want to reverse it. That's it. Well, we're good to go now. Let's see if everything is in order. Yeah, so we have our crane module installed, and with this we're going to move the storage module, and this will be another case of hauling. Everything on. Off we go. Okay, so what we want to do now is to connect the storage module to the refinery, so we can store the refined material there, and also we have a port. We will have a port to load and basically to load, because yes, to load and unload, because we want to load to the refinery the ore we mine in the mine, and then we want to unload all the refined material and load it to I don't know, some crate, and this will be like the last part that we will be transporting some refined ore from the mine to the base. Here's a nice flat area. We could have some, and I see that there's some material down there. We could have a mine also there. Let's start descending. So let's see how this goes, because as I said, I haven't tested this, something I have not tested. Another way that we can go sideways is like I should do this. If you see here, With the flight assist on, if I turn off the RCS thrusters and I do this like slight inclination, you see that we move sideways like a helicopter, because the lift thrusters are all the time being activated to keep the altitude. So this is also a way to control the attitude, or the side movement of the ship. You see there how the vector moves slightly. So this is also a way to control the sideway move without activating the RCS stuff. It's just a little nice trick. And let's see our position. Okay, it's not that bad. We're going to extend the crane. Extend the crane, also turn the ports on. Let's go down a little bit. We need to move. Yes. There, that's the maximum extension. Let's look at it from the other side, because on the other side we have the other installations, right? Okay, it seems good. It always tends to go a little bit to get some pitch movement there. There we are, almost in position. There. Okay, so we are attached now to the module, and you see here that we have now certain, it's not like we are out of the danger to hit the panels, but certainly we are in a better position, and even we could attach it the other way, right? We could also attach it in such a way that we are facing forwards, and maybe that's even better. Let's see. But in any case, it would be a good idea to just fold these things, right? First the rotors, solar plant rotor. So let's reverse this one and reverse that one. Which one is which here? The rotors. This is at 45. The other one is at 90. Okay. And 45. Zero. It should be at zero. Oh, okay. That's Then it will go at night. All right. So, and then we can just fold them. The hinge. Both of them. Reverse. Let's get out of the way so we don't get crushed. Yep, and that's it. Okay, so now we can just install it. I think we are out of danger of impacting the structure. Oh, okay. Main landing gear, yes. I don't know which one. Ah, this one's right. There. I don't see from here if we are at the right, yeah, we are aligned, but okay, no, that's perfect. Perfect, it even, it's going down a little bit. Okay, but I think it's a good. There. So now it's connected, and now we have to disconnect here. There. So everything is perfect. Oh, sorry. I left the whole crane. No, 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 no. This is not what I wanted to do. Oops. Okay. No, I just wanted to disconnect the crane, not the whole crane, but only the, yeah, you know what I mean, the storage module. Okay, so where is that? No, not that, this one, the 5. That's why it's always a good idea to check what you're doing. Now, this is what I wanted to do. Okay, and now we can just retract the whole thing, I think. Okay, and now we can return to the base. Well, let's check out our work and see what I was referring to. So now we have the storage module connected to the refinery here, as you can see. And these are the unmergeable blocks working for us here. The unmergeable block, what they do is what it says, right? You have these blocks that usually will merge, like these tubes. But the unmergeable blocks, it makes it in such a way that they are, once you unmerge the blocks here, the tubes will behave as the a merge block that is off, right? Like it will detach from the other. So that's what the mod does. But look at this. This is great. So now everything is set. And what I was saying is that this port here, this connector, will let us like bring a small ship that will mine the gold from the mine, and then it can put it into the refinery, right? Okay, so let's go back to the base. Let's go back to the base. So this is also hauling, right? This is what I was saying before. This is also hauling. Like, you need to move something from one place to another. It's like a when you have a truck moving a trailer, for example, and the trailer, I don't know, the trailer could be anything, any equipment or a house or something. And it's not like transporting some goods, but it's transporting equipment, and this is also hauling. Okay, so the base is there. Let's go for it. And there you have the shadow of the Eagle Transporter. The most unmistakable shadow. And now I will show you the other, like the other equipment I have to transport. Because now we need to transport, for example, the refined material to the base, and we could do that with a big storage module. Like we would take back the storage module back to the base once it's filled with material, but this would be really a lot of material. I think I wouldn't do that in my current game. It's not like very practical. But I want to show you another. I would probably transport this refined material in my small ships, because if you fill like a medium sized container with like gold ingots, it's already a lot of material. So probably this is what I would do. I would just take my small ships and do the hauling with those small ships. But let's say that you wanted to make some hauling with a haul some material with the Eagle Transporter, but you don't want you wouldn't do it with this big storage module. So I have a smaller storage module I want to show you guys quickly. I think we won't be doing anything else, but just to show you this, because I already think the video is long. You see it there, right? And we should like orient ourselves there. Okay. There. So now we are attached to it. You can see it here. It's this module right here, and it contains this. It has 5 containers, right? And it has a connector with a piston connected to a piston and a hinge, and this is meant like to be able to take cargo from easily from some structure below without getting too close, right? So now we can just detach this. Okay, but there we go, guys. This is my current configuration of the Eagle Transporter. You can use this module to also haul things. The best would be to have the module directly connected to the body of the, and not with this crane. Also, it could work like this. It's just that that somehow the structure is overflowing under the landing gears, so this doesn't seem optimal. But there you go. These are the different scenarios for hauling. Like, you are moving an equipment from one place to another, or you can be hauling goods from one place to another. And we have designed like several modules for that: the crane module, the small storage module, and the large storage module. So, and I think we will leave it here for this episode. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you tune in for the next episode. And this is Cyber Settler signing off.